الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to another session of Harari Da'wah. Inshallah ta'ala, today we will expand on our previous discussion of the intellectual proof for the presence of Allah Azza wa Jal. Previously, we had mentioned that something cannot come from nothing, because nothing does not exist. And if we ponder upon all the creations that come to be every day, from humans and animals and plants and everything else Allah Azza wa Jal puts into this universe, such as wind and rain and night and day, and if we ponder upon the state of the sun, the moon, the stars and the planets, and everything else that is present, the intellect determines with certainty that everything, all that I'd mentioned and that which I did not mention, cannot be from nothing. Just like Allah Azza wa Jal had said in Surah Al-Tur,
أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ أَمْ خَلَقُوا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ بَلْ لَا يُوقِنُونَ
So pondering upon that which is created points to the presence of its creator. Rather, it also points to some of the attributes of its creator. For example, if we see a wooden door that has been perfectly made, then we know that the person who made this door owned this piece of wood and was able to cut it up into perfect organized pieces and then make a door from this wood. Then we know that the person, the carpenter who made this wood door, is capable of making the door, and he is experienced and has the knowledge required to make the door. And this leads us to a conclusion, and that is, thinking and pondering upon the creations points us toward some of the attributes of the Creator. Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah Al-Jathiyah,
إِنَّ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَآيَاتٍ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَفِي خَلْقِكُمْ وَمَا يَبُثُّ مِنْ دَابَّةٍ آيَاتٌ لِقَوْمٍ يُوقِنُونَ واختلاف الليل والنهار وما أنزل الله من السماء من رزق وما أنزل الله من السماء من رزق فأحيا به الأرض بعد موتها وتصريف الرياح آيات لقوم يعقلون.
And this was the beginning. This whole universe was created and put in place with everything that is in it before the human being was created. And this is something everyone has to agree about, because no one can say that the skies and the earth came after the human being was created, that night and day came after the humans were created, and the oxygen that people breathe came after the humans were created. Similarly, the earth was prepared by Allah Azza wa Jal for humans to plant and to harvest their fruits and vegetables and everything else we get from the earth. Allah Azza wa Jal says in the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah,
هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ لَكُم مَّا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى إِلَى السَّمَاءِ ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَسَوَّاهُنَّ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ
And after that came the creation of the human being. Allah Azza wa Jal said in the next verse, وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً And remember when your Lord said to the angels, Verily, I'm going to place mankind, generations after generations, on earth. So all this points us toward the fact that this universe was put into place for the humans before they were created. And this points to the existence and presence of Allah Azza wa Jal, the All-Capable and the Creator of everything. Nothing in this universe goes according to the will of humans. Rather, Nothing even goes according to their own will. The sun cannot rise one day and be absent the second day. The wind doesn't decide where it blows. Rain doesn't decide when and where it comes down. No one from the humans, none of mankind, can claim that they have anything to do with the creation of all these things or in their continued existence. And all of this brings us to an important point, and that is those people who say that this universe came about or came to be randomly actually affirm the presence of a creator. However, instead of saying that Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who created everything, they say that the randomness is the creator. Randomness cannot create the perfect system we see in the universe all around us that hasn't disappeared in all of these years. And for those who say that life began with a cell, or life began with atoms that came together, we say, who is the one who created the first cell or the first atom? And who is the one who gave it or them the capability to come together to go and create life after that? And the person with intellect does not argue with people that have such ideologies. Rather, we say that Allah Azza wa Jal actually told us about these misleaders before they came to be. Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah Al-Kahf,
مَا أَشْهَدْتُهُمْ خَلْقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَا خَلْقَ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَمَا كُنْتُمْ مُتَّخِذَ الْمُضِلِّينَ عَضُدًا.
Allah Azza wa Jal created the first of everything and then put into place systems that allow these things to reproduce and to continue to be in existence. And all of this is with the order and the ability of Allah Azza wa Jal. And if we move on and look at the animals and birds and insects, then we see that all of them are from the creation of Allah Azza wa Jal. All of them came from a male and female of each respective species. Allah Azza wa Jal points us to this in the Quran and says,
وَمِن كُلِّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَا زَوْجَيْنِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ.
And if we think about this, that everything is created in pairs, even at the atomic level, subhanallah, we have positive and negative charges that go together in an atom. We have protons and electrons. And that points us towards the fact that this whole universe is based on pairs of everything. And there is a great challenge in Surah Al-Hajj by Allah Azza wa Jal for all of the creation, in which he says,
يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ ضُرِبَ مَثَلٌ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ لَنْ يَخْلُقُوا ذُبَابًا وَلَوْ اجْتَمَعُوا لَهُ وَإِنْ يَسْلُبْهُمُ الذُّبَابُ شَيْئًا لَا يَسْتَنْقِذُوهُ مِنْهُ ضَعُفَ الطَّالِبُ وَالْمَطَلُوبُ.
And this is a challenge by Allah Azza wa Jal that will be there till the Day of Judgment. And that is, all of the scholars, all of the humans of the world, regardless of how technologically advanced they become, if they were to come together to create a fly, just a fly, they won't be able to. And Allah Azza wa Jal chose the example of the fly because it is a very simple creation to point to the incapability of people. And I will conclude with one final point today, and that is, sometimes the perfection of all of these systems and that they continuously happen and continue to exist causes people to forget the one who put them into place and the one who created them. Just like sometimes the abundance of blessings from Allah Azza wa Jal causes people to forget who the one who provided all these blessings is. A person who is healthy and well a lot of times forgets about the blessing of health until he is sick. If someone was able to see normally with his own eyes and suddenly was afflicted with something in his eyes, then he remembers that Allah Azza wa Jal created his eyesight. And a beautiful example of this is the human heart, which starts to beat before someone is born. After the person is born, the person could live for 100 years and the heart would never stop beating. If it stops beating, the person would die. However, the point is, this person could live for 100 years and not realize that he has a heart. And I'm not referring to the spiritual heart, rather I'm referring to the physical heart, the organ. It is only when he feels pain in his heart or when something goes wrong and he has some sort of sickness in his heart, then he remembers that he has a heart. Similarly, everything else in the universe, sun rises and sets, night and day come and go, and all the other systems that Allah Azza wa Jal has put in place, sometimes people get used to them and forget that Allah Azza wa Jal actually created these. So people getting used to the consequence or the result of Allah Azza wa Jal's actions sometimes causes them to forget Allah Azza wa Jal. And this is something we should pay attention to. And we will end here today. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.